So as you got a glimpse of last time, I was modeling up some cardboard versions of the set of plates and lower mount that were going to be welded to the suspension console and would serve as the pickup point for the engine cradle rear mount. And here that is in place. Now here's a closer up view of the four components. There's the front and rear plates, the lower plate that is the mount pickup point, and then sort of that half moon shape that wraps itself around the lower edge of the suspension console. And here's that piece cut and fit to the suspension console. You can see it's got holes that'll be plug welded after the paint is removed from behind those holes, obviously. And then here is the rear plate being fit to that. And these are all done in light gauge sheet metal just to prove out the dimensions before I update CAD files and cut final pieces in the appropriate gauge material. And then with all the pieces modeled up, all the dimensions verified, and the pieces developed in CAD, they were all cut out on the plasma table, fit to the car, and tacked in place. Now you notice that the front plate is no longer an entire plate. The previous owner had already plated the front side of the suspension console, so rather than plating over that, I decided to just use a small extension piece and graft it on to the plate that was already there. It was much simpler and it left a really tidy result. And here's just another view of that same set of pieces tacked together, one from the top, and here a bit of a close-up from the side, just so you can see how things are shaped and how they fit onto the car. Then I just repeated those same steps on the other side, and with both sides ready to go, it was time to do some final welding.
Oh, when you don't have a rotisserie, ain't no fun. But it's good for flexibility. Let's see. Am I getting too old for this?
And here's a shot of the overall drivetrain mount approach. We've got the transmission hanger setup and the engine cradle. Not all fully welded on the engine cradle yet, but now it's time to move on to fitting the engine mounts proper. And what we are going to do today is position the engine back inside the chassis, but this time with our nearly completed engine cradle. So the effort today is to get this cradle bolted back into the chassis and then get the engine positioned in space so that we can line up the side plates for the motor mount and get everything positioned, get those tacked on, pull it all apart, weld it up on the bench, and then we will be ready to finally suspend this motor in the car with no jack. It'll be bolted in. It'll be totally awesome. So here we go. That is what you call clearance, Clarence. That's with the new quick jacks that we just got yesterday. Mm-hmm. And I was hoping that that would get high enough, and it does. And now you can also see the fabulous jack contraption in action. It doesn't roll quite like I would hope that it would, but it gets the job done. Okay, we're gonna put that in there. Got that about in position. Fun part is the quick jacks lower things diagonally, so I'm going to have to get this positioned and start lowering jacks and keep careful watch on things and probably move the engine around, but this is kind of how it looks in its current state. And you saw the other progress on getting the suspension console mounts put on there. They're not quite done, but they're done enough to support the motor. So we can at least make progress on getting the final location for those those engine mounts. But here we go. Well, all right. So there, whoop, let's do this first. There are the quick jacks in their low position, which is just about right for how high I like to take the jack with the motor on it. And let's do that. So I'm gonna do this one-handed, but this will give you an idea of how this whole thing works. There's just a foot pedal. And now, it's the first time I've done it with the engine cradle in here. And so what I gotta do is make sure that things aren't, whoa. Pardon me taking you on this crazy video ride, but I thought you might find this part interesting. Okay, so here you can see that the bungs from the mount are clear, but look what happens, right? Things big in the car, long in the car anyway. Yeah, the trans bumps into the body, so I gotta push it forward just a little bit so it clears. And keep doing it, because it also raises at an angle opposite of the opposite of the quick jacks. Ay, ay, ay. Isn't this fun? All right, so hold on a second. I'm going to kind of just try to find a spot where this camera can go whilst I wrestle this thing around, because I got to get... this is the first time it's done this, or I've had it on the quick jacks, first time with the engine cradle. First time. Okay, here we go. So I can see, you might not be able to, but the trans tab is coming up between the hanger tabs. The bosses are clear. The top boss is clear, and here it comes into position. So now, all I've ever had to do before is worry about the rear mount. Now I gotta worry about this thing. All right, so this has got to be there. That's got to be there. And the trans has got to come up a bit higher. A little bit higher. Here you can see the bolt. It's almost ready. A little bit farther forward. A little bit. Oh, looks good. And then just a tick more up. And then our hanger bolt. Look at that. Bam. As they say, bam. Again, sorry for the wild ride. But that, my friends, is in position. Now the fun begins. I have got to level the motor front to back to determine the height, and then I got to get the front of it centered. You wouldn't know it by looking, but these mounts, you can see that it's off center. There will be some shims, which I haven't made yet, that absolutely locate that in the center. But that rubber mount is super, super, super rubbery and wobbly, and it's not like I can just crank that down and have it center the motor. So it's gonna be a game of shoving the motor side to side at the front while it's pivoting around that mount to get it equidistant, well, centered in the car. And then we'll put the plates in. I'll show you that in a bit, but I'm calling that successful. You can see the gap there, about an inch plus, and you can see over here, it's almost touching. So the motor's shifted to the left a bit, which is fine. Right now, it's just about getting it in there with the engine cradle in place, which it is. Look at that. The holes even line up. I haven't even tried. Awesome. All right. We'll be back in a bit with more. Take care. Okay. So we are back with more. Here is the continued fun. And the continued fun is with the jack under the car and the engine cradle under the car, but not yet with the mounts on it. And let me just back up and first point out that what I've done is I've just set the side plates for the motor mounts in there. And you can see, now you get an idea how this is all gonna work. There's a center plate. I should have been better prepared. I'll just go over here to the bench and grab the center plate. But this is the center plate. Well, let's call it the center plate. This will live, obviously, under the motor mount, you know, bolted to those four holes. And then this dimension from the holes out to the bar, this was built long because I didn't know exactly where these things might end up. I knew approximately and I measured, but with welding dimensional changes and all that other fun stuff, what I'm now in a position to do is bolt this, well, actually I'll measure this distance on this side, I'll measure the distance on the other side and divide by two, and then I'll know that I know exactly how long to make this dimension. So I can cut these to size and bolt them to that mount, and that'll help actually center the motor. And by the way, this is strapped on to the handy dandy Harbor Freight engine hoist. And it's strapped around the Ferrari engine mounts. And it's actually scootable. Well, I didn't have it jacked up high enough, but I can scoot the thing back and forth and it sort of floats in space, which means I can get everything positioned to get all these things tacked in. And by the way, these literally just slide into place with enough clearance that once we get them, once we get this dimension tacked, you know, we can square them and get them 90 and all that good stuff. And then that gets tacked in place in situ with the entire assembly in there where we want it. And then we'll pull everything back out and bench weld it completely, where access is much easier and we can get higher quality welds and all the other great stuff. And then this motor is ready to go in to its final resting place. Now, part of the game is you can see it currently says 0.7 of degrees. And you'd think, well, don't you want that level? And the answer is no, because the car is not sitting completely level. So we have to play that game of, you know, leveling the engine to the chassis, if you will. So that still has yet to be done. But how cool is that? Now, again, with the one plate missing, but now you get a whole complete idea of what this whole motor mount situation is going to be like. And I couldn't be happier. It looks super awesome. So the next episode will be spending time getting all of that in place, tacked, and ready for final welding. So we are literally maybe a day away, or one more day of work away, from this being completed, at least this stage being drivetrain mounted, which is a huge milestone and been a long time coming. Thanks for going along with us on the ride, and we'll see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.